So I continue this video playthrough of upfront rear guard action. So the Americans are on the rear guard and the Germans trying to catch up and eliminate half of that rear guard. And it's over to the German turn. They don't have any rally cards here. Not a lot they can be doing. I think they're just going to, all they can do is discard. That's quite a poor move. Okay. The Americans have a rally, so they're going to rally this fellow. Actually, the other one who's got a worse panic level. Okay. With this group, they're going to try and repair that semi-automatic rifle, which they managed, that had been malfunctioned. So that's the American turn, and the German turn. Maybe we're going to have to move these guys off the hill. They're really enjoying some firepower on them, though. Yeah, okay, so they're going to... Have they still got it? So where are we at? We're at 3, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 firepower, and that's 8. That's a shame to get off the hill, but they're in a gully. They're going to have to come out of it soon. Okay, we're going to assume those guys are moving out of the gully. So they're going up to relative range chip 5 plus 1, relative range of 1. These guys, hang on a sec. Yes, of course, it's relative range 4 because it's 6 minus 2 is 4. So when they stop moving, they're going to get 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 firepower out of that group at that range if they can keep it. And we wanted smoke here, but you need a impend SR or S squad leader. Yeah. And the assistant squad leader is pinned, so they're just going to discard the smoke. Because they're probably going to be moving, so it won't come in that handy anyway. That doesn't gain them anything good. Okay, back to the Americans. The Americans need another movement. They're going to drop a wire on these fellows and discard that movement card. So back to Germans. So they've got the firepower now, but with the wire on them and being movement, it's not going to be effective at all. But they can play this as a movement card, okay, to remove the wire and discard that. Okay, so the Americans can rally. Here, relative range of 3, don't have enough firepower for this, so that's all they can do. These could try and entrench, they will try it now, okay, so that's Jim's great, they needed that rally card. He's ostensibly crewing the machine gun. He's now, because he's a crew, he can automatically pick it up next turn. Now he's unpinned. This is a movement. I might continue that movement. Can you go higher than 6? Yes, it's just illustrative purposes that their diagram only goes up one. So, however, it doesn't help them. No. So what I'm going to say, they're going to get into these woods. So now they won't be able to fire into the gully, but then they move further forwards, they can. And they rallied, I believe, didn't they? So we could do a discard. That's kind of clogging the hand, that string. I'm keeping that, but you must keep it. Okay. Now the Americans have got nothing helpful, so they're going to discard. Thinking to keep that gully, to put these into as soon as they come out of this gully. Okay, so where are we with the Germans? They've now got... nine, so they've got five, they can, ooh, nice, they can bring four fire factors from out of the woods onto these, no, because they're in woods, aren't they, and these are in the gullies, yeah, when they were on the hill it was okay, but now they're not in their line of sight, they could bring it onto those guys though, seeing as they are adjacent to, no, they're not adjacent to them, so that's, but that's, okay, net effect is it's the same range, relative range as to these, so that's okay. So, because minus one here and six here gives us five, but then it goes down one because these two groups are not adjacent, which goes down to four. Still got enough fire, so they're bringing fire onto these. Then these, this group can move forward. They'll be at relative range five. If these are pinned, these get to it'll be relative range four. So they need to move two ranges forwards before these ones can move away. So yeah, we want to pin these now. Forget about this group. Because we needed a five. Men and they're down to four. So yeah, it's the old plan. Get on this group, eliminate this group. But we can't, they're hidden in the gully at the moment, so we're not going to waste the fire card. We're going to hopefully pin some of these. So that's four, but they have a conceal of two, so that brings it down to two. They're in the woods of minus two, so that's base zero. Still worth taking in my book. Nope. No, he's got morale five. No. Okay, maybe not. Worth taking. I could check the odds. I've got the percentage chances, and I might do that and I'll analyze that together with you guys. Another shot. Okay, so they've taken action. Are these guys going to take an action? They've got one, six, seven firepower, so they can do the same. Seven firepower, bringing four fire factors onto these again. And then the last fire card, the mortar can join in, switch there to hit. Maybe not, I think I'll keep them on there. But anyway, these fellows against these, so they're going to have to use another concealed, which brings us to base one. Plus one, no, one, minus two, one, minus one, one, plus two is three, yes, pinned, one, plus four is five, so he's pinned two. Okay, and then, yes, that fire. It's not adjacent, so it's... relative range zero. C. 6 is a miss. Anyway, okay. Any discard? No. That was the German turn. I'm feeling kind of split because we concentrate on this group and he's not adjacent to the mortar, so the mortar's got further range. It would have been happier to concentrate on this group, so it might be better to bring those two. And then I want this group because I really want to bring them all onto the one group we're trying to take out. So the question just is that going to stick with that further range to them, or these will have to be at further range to them? Because these are in the gully, it would suggest it's been wise to change target at the moment. Okay, it's a bit late for that now. So where are we? The American turn. They need some rallies. They have a rally 6, so they get to rally those two guys. This one can take a movement. They've got the movement card they need. So now they're slightly dangerously out of the gully, but they're at retrograde minus 3, retrograde 3. And we've just finished the second deck, so it's looking sweet for the Americans. They're two-thirds of the way away from winning. Again, they just have to hang in there, keep moving slowly backwards, and they will make it. Of an opportunity in that I could move this up further and then one of these guys could move into there and then that would be big enough to move up on here and gain a win, but it's going to take a lot of movement cards to do. Okay, so where are we? The Americans are replenishing their hand, and now it's the German turn. They're actually at relative range 5. No, because they're not adjacent. Yep, okay. These guys. Okay, this is moving up to relative range 4, so to range chip 4, which brings them at the same range chip as here, and then I'm going to try and transfer guy out into there, which is going to make the mortar pretty useless, but I think that's the chance of the win, then bring them up to them. Now while they're moving up to them, hopefully, and these guys will be pressuring this group, so they won't have enough movement cards to both move back. Either this one will get obliterated by them or this one will get closed in by them is the plan. So meanwhile, please do get to fire. Fire of 2. Okay, so one of those movement cards, because it's a gully, only one of those movement cards will count. So that will add 1. So that's 5 factors of 3. They have no concealed cards, so 3 plus 0, 3 plus 3 is 6, he's pinned. 3 minus 3 is 0. 3 minus 1 is 2, and he's moving on 3, so pin one fellow with that. And then we discard the stream onto them. Bang, so they cannot reject that. They're they're stuck in an unpleasant position and able to be victimised by fire from here. Replenishing the hand. Okay, what do the... They have no rally. Americans are not happy. Do they have... Can they fire upon here, perhaps? They do have... Maybe they can combine fire. Maybe these could fire out upon them even. Or them. But let's first see here. Try and mess up the German plan here. So relative range is 3. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 5 and 6, 7. So we can use both of these together, which gives us fire factors of 4 out against them. -2 for the wall, +1 for the movement is -1. So that's fire factors of 3. They have no concealment, so base 3 plus 3 is 6, so we pin him, -4, the other guy's okay. I pause then because I remembered I forgot that this guy could pick up this weapon. I think he's had the opportunity to, which I mislaid. With them not taking action last turn, I believe. So I'm going to say he picked up that light machine gun, so he's now holding a light machine gun instead of a machine pistol, and perhaps one of these could crew it for him. We'll see. So anyway, back to where we were. So he was pinned, and can we do anything here? No. German rally 1. Okay. No, in fact, instead of that rally, I'm going to drop them into the brush, so he's still pinned. They found some terrain. These ones are going to move forward, so no, because I need them to transfer. Okay, keep that. And I'll just discard. So, oh, and as an action, he's going to try and crew that, which means yeah. Okay, so he's now. Hang on, at this range, say range of relative range of 3. We've got firepower 7 or 4, so it's +3. So losing, okay, so we do gain from that overall firepower for him dropping his Mauser, picking up the bullet belt. Okay. And replenish. So the Americans have got some nice fire cars, so they could fire again, you see. But they're stuck in the stream, they're -1 firing out. And I'm not sure if a bar can fire out. Yeah, I think they can, it's not a light machine gun or anything. But what firepower do we have here? So it's 3, what was it? It was 9, wasn't it? Not quite enough for any of them. Damn. So we're going to chuck some of this away and just draft the American hand, which gives Germans the opportunity. They rally the mortar. In fact, I don't need to bother with that, because the important bit here is that this guy is trying to transfer across to here. Yeah, okay, so in an individual transfer, instead of sort of moving the whole group into a different identity, this C could move that way and become D. So I place this sideways, I play it sideways. Do I need to leave it on the table? No, just discard it. So I discard it, but I put a transfer chit on him. So now he's, if either of those groups is fired at, he's liable to be targeted at a plus two, but he will get a terrain modifier from it. Okay, so that's that group. Action, this group. Nothing, this group, nothing I can do there. Okay, I think I'm going to discard the rally one. Get an extra card in. Okay, over to the Americans, and they do have enough firepower to use this card. So he's going to fire on this group, and that guy's likely to be pinned. That's a real unfortunate. And I could only do the transfer because we have an assistant squad leader or a squad leader here in either of the groups. So they're firing out on this group. So fire strength of four, and that'll be six against him. he's going to be lucky if he doesn't get killed. Have we got a concealment card? No, I should have waited till we had a concealment card. Too late now, so we'll do him first. So 6 plus 4, and he's dead. Shot in the head, under orders from his assistant squad leader, come over here. 4 minus 3, 4 minus 0, he's pinned. 4 minus 2, he's pinned. 4 plus 2, he's pinned. Okay. Yes, it's that kind of silly action where you want to prepare it more. But it's that other thing as well, is the more you're preparing, you know, you're discarding, your opponent can also be doing the same, saying, okay, well, I can see you're getting ready, I'm going to get ready. when does one do it? Okay. Guys fire. No. Okay, so punish the American hand. So if we had a rally all, I could have rallied all of those. Because we have an unpinned ASL there, but we don't. So I use the rally 4 to rally these two guys. Now both my wonderful German plans have been scuppered. That original manoeuvre plan was scuppered, and then this manoeuvre plan was scuppered. I could try, if he's unpinned, we could try and move him over at a later time. What I'm going to do, I'm going to play the hero to rally him, so try and make sure he isn't obliterated. And 8 firepower. So 2 fire strength, fire effects of 2 plus, minus 2, 0. Any concealment? Yes, so they have minus 1, so fire strength minus 1. Are we going to take it? We're in our last deck. as the Germans know, they're just going to replenish their hand. Now the Germans haven't lost half their original squad, but they're getting towards there. If they did, they've lost four men. If they did, then they would forfeit the game. No, these haven't got quite enough firepower to play that card, so they're just going to be discarding. They're looking for a rally and a lower firepower. And they get neither. They do get a wire, which is not a bad thing. And they get a movement, which could help them out of the stream. So the Germans, they can out, with these guys start, it's going to make sense to concentrate on taking that out, back to that plan. Oh, and now they're in the stream that they lose the 2-hit frequency number, because there's some movement there. Okay, so, but the Germans only have one fire card here, 17. Can't muster that yet. They do have the movement. Gonna risk it, so he's gonna try for a transfer. And you're allowed to do that to eliminate the group by individual transfer. Yeah. Now that can't use the mortar, so we're going to discard that. Fortunately, the Americans don't have a fire card, they do have wire. Could they put wire on him? Yes. I'll just check if wire affects transfers. Okay, yeah, the rules as written would mean that he's more exposed. If I play the wire on this group, he's more, even more exposed to attack, but it's not actually, which is what the Americans are going to do, but he's not actually, he can still transfer. In fact, so that's not, as their action next turn, they will move that transfer chip and he's there, so in fact, that's not going to do anything. However, this is the group most threatening us anyway, so I think we're going to play that. Discard that on them, and also this, still trying to get a rally, excellent. Okay, so they are playing this to bring him into their group. Well done, sorry your friend got it, bought it. This group can play, use that as a movement. That's what we're going to do. So we are at range chip 7, relative 4 to them. I'll discard that. Okay. And the Americans get to rally, which means they can now start to try and move out of the stream. These guys. Or they could move. It's more important they move, I think, because if the fire doesn't work, this group can move up. Okay, so they're moving. No, they need a retrograde movement card, and that's not one. Okay, so they're going to fire. So that's 4 plus 1 onto this group, so that's 5. strength. Concealed 2 brings it down to 3. That's still pretty high. Plus 0, minus 5, minus 2, minus 0, so he's actually pinned, minus 0, he's pinned 2, okay, that was the American turn. Germans rally these two. And now that mortar can actually fire from there, but that would be the only action of that group. So they're actually going to bring these into some closer woods and discard that fire card. The Americans are looking for fording the stream or okay, they can't use that movement, so they play that, and if they get a black random number check, which they do, that does it. So the next card they play can be a terrain to get out of the stream. And these fellows cannot benefit with that fire card, so that's it. They could try and entrench, which they will. No, they missed it. Okay. So the German turn. These guys are going to get away again soon. These ones we want to get close to. These ones we want to shoot. Okay, that's the German turn. And they jump out into another gully, which was their plan all along. So now they're hidden from sight, both the German groups. Now the mortars are not going to be as in action as much. That's sweet. These ones are pretty much safe, I would say. We're almost halfway through the last deck. So now the action's all going to be on this American group, who are able to do nothing with that. But they can try to entrench. No, they don't get it. Entrenchment might not be, it might just be finding better cover within the woods. Not literally, they're getting their spades out and digging. Okay, so the Germans, they need movement and fire now, but not this paltry fire factors of 2. I'm going to move these over just to make it, since I've got some space from losing men, to make it a bit clearer to me that they are opposite, they are not adjacent to them. I can get rid of this. This group A doesn't exist anymore. So they have no one opposite them. And these fellows are opposite. Okay, so I'm going to fire from here. Relative range here is 3. Actually, that mortar, I could fire that on a 0 to 3 chance of hitting. I get a 0, so it hits. I just forgot to play the steel cover. Anyway, so they're in woods, so that brings it down to a 0. 0 minus 6, ouch. that malfunctions the mortar. I think I have to. No, we carry on, but I think I have to check. I think we carry on, but it won't be able to fire again until repaired. Oh, okay. So no, it's only the resolution of the two hit, not the damage resolution that counts. Okay, so that basically means that guy is okay. This guy, fine, fine, oh, just okay. Ah, -6/1. So that did nothing. And we'll have a. We'll discard. Concealed. I'm going to keep the hill. They can get up on the hill, bring fire down on them. The wall for the any movement from these guys. No, I'll keep the concealed. They can't go anywhere without a movement anyway. Okay, so the Americans. They could retrograde and move. No, that's car for the Americans. There's nothing they can do, so they're going to discard these two. I really need to get a crew member onto that. But at the moment, no, he crewed that, didn't he? So relative range of 3, we've got 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I've got that fire onto them. Okay. So that's 4, -2, -1, so that's base 1, plus 3, pinned, base 1, plus 0, minus 2, plus 2 is pinned, minus 2, okay, so, and this group can't do anything. Could try and entrench, but no, they're going to be moving, don't want to waste that. So we've got movement, that's good. Now, these guys, they need a rally, they don't have it. They need retrograde movement, they don't have it. That gully would be nice to get on these. So they're going to discard those. Two. Oh, look at that, the Americans, nothing useful for them. I mean, that's useful, but they need a movement with a red number up there to move retrograde. They could move sideways into the gully. Yes, that would be worthwhile to do, but not while these are pinned. Anyway, so over to the Germans. They've got movement. That's interesting. So that brings them up to relative range of 4. Can we do anything there? No. Okay. Still nothing the Americans can do, is there? So, oh yeah, I think I'm going to move them sideways. No, because they're pinned. Ah. Okay, we'll get rid of two of those. Just discard. Which has given Germans breathing space to pop these guys up on a hill. They can now fire down into there, and they're a bit of cover moving up on those. And we'll discard that one fire card. We don't get anything good in return. Shucks, might have needed to use that. Never mind. Yeah, in fact, I could have used it from there. Too late now. In fact, these are 5, 6, 7, that's at minus 1, which is relative range of 6 being higher than 5, that becomes 4, which means this group is actually behind them. The danger of being encircled, but I think that's only going to happen if they're adjacent and they're not adjacent. I should be thinking about flanking a group which is behind an adjacent enemy group, yeah, can encircle. Yeah, and flanking fire only happens versus adjacent groups as well. So unfortunately it's not adjacent to them. Can't get benefits of that. Where was I? It was American go. They can't do anything. Except perhaps play that. Looking for flanking fire, but they're not looking for a firefight. They're into retreating slowly. Okay, the Germans are pretty stymied as well. So all they can do at this point is discard one. Let's get some nothing they want. Okay, what this does is these could perhaps fire up on the hill. So they're at relative range of 2. So we've got 3, 4, 5, 6 firepower. So that group can fire up on the hill. Ah, and that would be in lieu of a discard. So that would be the only action. Yeah, we're going to take that. So that's firepower of 2 minus 1. So that's 1. Minus 1 brings it to 0. Okay, no effect, but it is running out of time, forcing the Germans to halt their procedures. So we've got less than half a deck left for the Germans to bring those one more range chip and then in terrain without these being able to move away. They almost got enough firepower at this range with just those 3 men onto there, but not quite enough for that. Okay, so the Germans are being a bit stiff, aren't they? So drop that. This is where they want that discard 2 capability of the Americans, but they haven't got it. They've got a movement, that's what they want. What do the Americans have? Rally 4. Perfect. They also have got what they want. This group. Try and entrench, so get a better cover in the gully. No, okay. So, coming down to the wire. This is where I should stop and say, okay, this is critical. Don't want to mess it up, really. We've got the building's cover. So what needs to happen is that these are going to move forward, which gets them close enough to these, and they've got 5 men in the group to win the game, but then they need to be unpinned and in building's terrain. So they can move forward this turn, they've got the card, but now this and or this, because they'll still be on a hill, either of these could fire at them. If they get pinned, they can go into the buildings, then it'll be another turn before they can unpin those men, and that's going to give 2 turns in which this can find movement cards to move back. That's the situation, they're going to have to go for it. So don't think we can dilly-dally at this point. We could sit and wait, see if we get smoke or something. And we'll bet a concealed card, but then they might get the movement, so I can't afford that. So that's bringing us up to range chip 6 versus 1, so relative range 5 here. And this group can do nothing. I'll just discard that. So it's not a terrible position because we've got concealed and we had to have the rally if we need either of those. The question is, can the Americans fire? We've increased our rate, we've closed the range to them, increasing the relative range, so they're now at 3, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, they can now use this fire card, which of course is Germans, we didn't know. So having got a bit closer, mainly concentrate these guys are now able to fire at them. They're still on the hill till we play another terrain card or another movement. So the gully and the hill are in line of sight of each other. So we have 4 plus 1 minus 1 cancels out. So that's 4 minus 1 for the concealed. This is really crucial. This could be the game deciding moment if any of those get pinned. Well, you know, it will depend on what comes after that, but I mean, they are going to be able to recover quickly, so it really depends if they stay, the pin is, gives enough of a breather, one more turn breather for them to find the movement card that can get them away. Let's see. So what, where were we at? We were at 3, base 3. Okay, we've got morale 2, 2, 3, 4, and 3. So, base of 3 minus 2, base of 3 minus 1, base of 3, 0, so that's 3, so he's pinned. Base of 3 plus 2 is 4, pinned. Doesn't really matter if 1 or 5 are pinned. Base note because we've got the rallies. Excellent. So the Americans are happy with their performance. They can't do anything else. Oh, he could try and entrench. They don't manage to. The Germans rally all. And not wasting this fire card now. So he's firing across to them, so they're behind them, but they're still in the woods, so it's still relative range of 6, 7, what did I say, 6, that's 4, so we definitely got a firepower for it, but fire factor's 1 minus 2. So that's fire strength of minus 1, minus 2 for conceal, minus 3. Do we bother trying? No, I don't think so. But now the question is, I need that for them. Do I discard that rally? And they're looking for another fire factor. No. So I might need one rally. Okay, so yes, concealed of minus 2. So any more fire from the Americans? Not doing too badly. So, and the Americans don't have any fire. What they do have is wire and nothing else to do, so they are discarding. In lieu of a discard, they put this wire on them, so they cannot jump into rain until they got, oh, until they got rid of that wire. Okay, good move. And they got another one. So even when they take it out, it'll come back. Okay, and they haven't got anything to take it away either. no chance of playing anything there on these, so they only get one card. So I think you can place more than one wire on a group. Effect's going to be the same anyway. Okay. So on the German turn, they take off one of the wires and they discard that coward card for them. Movement. And the Americans are taking their movement from them, so the Americans gleefully discard two movement cards. Still not the retrograde movement they want there. Not even bothering to stop to fire, looking for retrograde movement. The Germans go curses. At least we can put down some fire from our hill. Be relatively ineffective. Could be on them. Yeah, forget the gully guys, it's on them still. I want to pin them. So, but minus two, so that's zero. Minus one for being in the wire. And it's half. Because we're moving, when do we factor in the half? So probably start with one for moving fire, plus one for firing off the hill, so that's two, minus one for wire, minus one, minus two for woods. Oh, I lost myself there, so those two cancel out. Wire brings that down to one, and the minus two makes it minus one. Okay, concealment of minus three, no. I'm not going for it. I'm going to discard that. Okay. And the Americans, they're not even going to fire. They're looking for that retrograde movement. Maybe they're going to fire next go. Okay. No movement. What firepower do they have? They could always fire the mortar. No, I don't need to fire a mortar from out of. Check that, but otherwise what five factors do we have? Five, so we've got nine. There, nine plus six is 15, so we could actually fire that card. So as moving fire, it's down to three, minus three, so we're on zero fire strength. We're going for it. Plus one, no, zero, minus one, nothing, damn. Discard. Okay. Okay, we're going to do lateral movement into the gully. Which probably means they're going to stop. Can they stop? No. They can't move back onto the hill. They could stay where they are. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to discard these two. Running out of time for the Germans and looking for the retro movement. Okay, and Germans looking at the time, rapidly running out for them. They need a movement card. All they need is a movement card and one more turn. Okay. One of these at a time. No. Someone's been card counting and has checked out how many movement cards are left. They're laughing. We're down to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cards. So that's 2 and 1. So that's sort of 3 more turns each side. Okay. It looks like it's over for the Germans.